Hi, I'm Todd from Metronome Music and Cycle to Go, and I've been getting some questions about installing Tannus tires on smaller rooms. So today I'm going to show you some tips and tricks that I've picked up for installing the Tannus tires on the smaller wheels. Today we're going to install one on the front wheel of a Brompton bike, which has a 16-inch wheel. So whenever you start any Tannus tire installation, the first thing you want to do, obviously if there's a tire on there, you want to pull the tire off. But the other thing you want to do is you always want to remove the rim strip before you install it. The rim strip normally protects the tube from getting punctured, but since the Tannus tire doesn't have that problem, you don't need it, and I found that it can actually break apart and kind of ball up underneath if you leave it in place. So you always want to remove that anytime you do a Tannus tire install. When you get your Tannus tire, it comes in a bag. There are two densities. One's a hard, one's a soft. This is a hard. The hard is the one I tend to prefer because it has a little less rolling resistance, but the soft is also really nice because it gives a real comfortable ride. Along with your tire, you get a little packet that has the installation tool. Which looks like this. And then depending on the tire you get, you'll get different color sets of tabs. So with Brompton, we get a set of red, blue, and purple. And each one of these is a different width depending on the size rim that you're going to be using. So in this case, the smallest ones are 21.5, 22.5, and 23.5. So the first thing you want to do is determine the width of your rim and the appropriate size tabs for it. To do this, you can either use a ruler with millimeter markings, or if you have it, a dial caliper. So to start with, I'm zeroing it out. Getting the measurement of the rim. I'm going to zero that out, and then you want to get the tab that is closest to 3.5 millimeters wider than that inner measurement. And it can go a millimeter either direction, so you can go as small as 2.5 or as big as 4.5. So on the smallest tabs, this one is 3.83, so that's going to be the one we're going to want to go with. If we went to any of the other larger ones, it would jump up above the 4.5 millimeter. Here's a close-up view of the locking tabs or pins. We're going to be using the purple 21.5 millimeter tabs for this tire that are on the far left. They're the ones I found are used on most of the modern Bromptons. On some of the older Bromptons, I found that they're a little bit wider rim, and we've used the 22.5, but you always need to measure your rim to make sure you get the right size tab. If you don't have a digital or dial caliper, you can also measure your rim just using a regular ruler. So in this case here, we can see that it's just shy of 18 millimeters. So you know that you want to get a tab that's about 21.5 in width. So again, if we go over to the tabs, we can see that that one, the purple, is marked at 21.5 millimeters, which is 3.5 wider than that inner measurement. So again, the purple is the one we're going to want to use for this particular tire. Okay, now that we've selected our tabs, we need to install them into the tire. Each little tab has a flat side and a rounded side. And then the holes in the tire also have kind of a flat toward the outside and a rounded toward the inside. So when you put these in, you put the flat side toward the outside, rounded side toward the middle. So it's usually easiest to do this on a flat surface. And to start with, I usually go around and just kind of set them all in place. Okay, so now that we have all the tabs in place, we're going to go around using the flat part of the installation tool and push them all down into place. So now we have all the tabs in. You want it to be pretty much equidistant if you can. And now that we've done that, we're ready to go ahead and start putting it on the rim. Now the trick with the small rims is it's easier to push the tabs in place when you have the tire in place on the rim, but it's hard to put the tire in place on the rim until you have at least a few of the tabs pushed into place. So with these, I usually find it's easiest if you kind of angle one side in and then have the other side open. Then if you place it on the ground between your feet, you can kind of rest it against your ankle. You want to use, I have the curved part of the tool toward the outside, and you want to push on the tab, putting pressure as close to the center of the tab as you can, because that's where it's going to flex the easiest. And you're just pushing down until you get a nice snap. And then if the tire is sticking out a little bit, you can just work it in with the tool as you work your way around. And then as you're going, just make sure that the tabs aren't popping out on the other side. But as long as you're kind of pushing it in place as you go, it should lock right in. Okay, and after you get it, I don't know, I guess I've done about 6 or 7, enough to kind of hold it in place. You want to go ahead and stretch the tire onto the rim. And I found the easiest way to do this is to, in a sitting position with the tire in your lap, you can use the lever to kind of pry it on. You want to hold it down here with your arm, and then you hold it with this hand as you pry it over the edge. So here, holding it, moving it a few inches, then you just kind of work your way around. Once you get it all the way over the rim, you just slide the tool out. And then again, I like to slide it so that it's angled in. One side of the tabs are in all the way around. One side's exposed. And then you can just finish going around, pushing in the tabs. And at this point, it's going to be a lot easier because you have the tire kind of pulling itself into the rim from the pressure being stretched over. Take a little bit longer to install than a standard tire, but it's well worth the effort, as you will not ever be having to do this on the side of the road with a flat tire. So here I'm just gonna work it in, and now we can see all the tabs are in on this side. None of them are sticking out. Same on that side, and this tire is ready to go. We can pop that on the bike, and it's ready to ride for many, many miles.